Good morning, my dear students and friends. Welcome back to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 18. In today's session, we'll see about stepper motor control using PLC. Yesterday, I explained something about controlling stepper motor through Arduino. See, from the point of view of stepper control, the PLC and Arduino both are equally good actually. Okay, now we'll come to the stepper motor control in PLC. In stepper motor control through PLC, you require a high speed PLC board, a high speed PLC board with a transistor output. So this is the board I used. It is a transistor. You can see the transistors here. You can see the transistors here, right? Let me open this in another application, so then you won't have this kind of a shadow effect. Okay, now this is the PLC board that I used. You see that these are the transistors. You won't see the relay here. So this is the input side, this is the output side. There are transistors here. This particular board can control up to two stepper motors only, right? Because the output points should have a high speed transmission rate. So only the four points Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, because you need two Y outputs for one stepper motor. So then the Y0 and Y1 are high speed inputs. So Y0 and any other from Y2 to Y12, you can use it for controlling a single stepper motor. Okay, so high speed PLC is required, number one, transistor type, and again NPN transistor type, high speed PLC you should buy and you should have, if at all, if you want to control a stepper motor through PLC. Now let us see in the picture. This is the PLC, then this is the 24 volt SMPS, then this is the driver that controls and connects the stepper motor, the PLC and the stepper motor. This is the stepper motor. So there is a pointer I provided, right? So this is the setup. Now here this is the main code which is supposed to be used in the ladder logic program, DDRVI S1, S2, D1, D2. DDRVI is a command. Like DDRVI, there are 3 or 4 more commands available in PLC, but I used DDRVI command only, where S1 is equal to number of pulses. For example, if the S2 value is equal to K1600, then this board has some dip switch. So connecting all these things, you see, if it in the board, if the dip switch is set to 800, so 1600 by 800, 2 revolution it makes. That means instead of 1600, you put 800, you will get only one rotation or one revolution, so multiples of 800. Okay, yeah, suppose if you want a four rotations, 800 by into 4, 3200 you have to put here. So this is the logic. Okay, second point is, if K, this S1 value, if it is positive, that is clockwise. If it is negative, counterclockwise. That is K, for positive you need not put plus, for negative K minus 1600 you have to put. Then S2, the pulse output frequency, the same way the dip switch in the controller driver is set at 800, you know. So K800 means it rotates at 60 RPM. Okay, so that is the logic. If suppose the K value is 1333, you will get 100 RPM. So this is the base. For 8, if you put 800 in S2, that is equal to 60 RPM. So that is the equation. Then D1 and D2, the pulse output number that you are supposed to use. So here in this particular model, Y0 and Y1 having high speed output. So Y0 and Y2 I am using. Okay, Y0 for the D1 and Y2 for the D2 maybe. Right, so that is about this one. Then in the driver, the driver board, it has the connections like this. PLA plus connected to plus 24 volt DC, PLA minus either Y0 or Y2, only these two are high speed output. DAR plus again 24 volt DC, DAR minus Y1 or Y3 or even any other value, ENA plus 24 volt, ENA minus I am not using now. So this is the setup. Based on this only the connections were made, especially for this Y0 and Y1, it should be connected through a 1K resistor because to prevent the overcurrent or over voltage maybe. And this is the ladder program that I made. For example, if you use X0, then it start executing this one actually. So DDRVI, K100, K50, Y0 and Y2. So this value will be changing based on the inputs. For example, this Y0, Y2 is fixed, constant. This will be the K100 and first K and second K will be varying. So for X0, first value is K100, second value is K50. For X1, K-100, K50. So K-100 means counterclockwise. Okay, so this is the program that I made. I used 13 inputs, right? So all the 13 inputs I used. If I press X0, half a revolution counterclockwise, 15 at the rate of, it will rotate at the rate of 15 rpm. It takes only 2 seconds. Similarly, X1 clockwise, half a revolution clockwise, 15 rpm. X2, one revolution anti-clockwise, 30 rpm, and so on. Finally, X11 means 8 revolution it makes, it rotates clockwise at the rate of 120 rpm. X12, 10 revolution counterclockwise, the speed is at the rate of 180 rpm. It takes only 3.3 seconds actually. Okay, so this is the program, this is the logic. For that I used X2 is here. So I have to play with the K, first K and second K only, based on the chart. Okay, so let me go at a faster rate. X7, X10, X11, X12. If you see X12, 2600, this 2000 corresponds to 10 revolution, and 600 corresponds to 180 rpm. So that is a logic. Okay, now we'll see those things in action. Now let me play it. Now for this one, for switch, instead of using the switch, I used a small wire to short either X0 or X1, X2 and so on. Okay, this is the wire. Now you see that. So this is the chart actually, this is the chart I already showed you. So this is the chart I showed you here also, right? Okay, at least we'll see it in action for some of the points if possible. Now I am power is on now, right? You see the this is on, SFBC is also on. So using the wire, I'll be shorting the X0 maybe first. Now, so the pin, this is the pin now. You see, it is rotating. Now let me go back. Now I'm touching here. Now you see that half rotation. Then next one, clockwise half rotation. You see here, anti-clockwise, 30 RPM, half rotation, 30 RPM clockwise, two revolution faster rate, anti-clockwise, two revolution faster rate clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4 rotations anti-clockwise still faster. 4 rotation clockwise still faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 anti-clockwise fast. Clockwise 8 times fast. And the last one is the fastest 10 RPM. 10 rotation 180 RPM. So you cannot see that one here in this video because the refresh rate here is very slow. So this is how you can make a program. Okay, so anyway, I'll copy this content in the link actually, but to test it you should have these things with you. You should have these things, right? This high speed PLC, even this compatible PLC, cost of this compatible PLC is also somewhere 6000 rupees or so, 6000 rupees or so. So that's why a bit costlier actually, but it will work precisely, right? Again, you need at least 20 amps, 24 volt SMPS, because it stepper motor will draw more power. So this controller, the driver, stepper driver, you should buy it. Okay, so that's about today. So I hope you got some information at least. I didn't teach, but I gave some information about how we can use PLC to control stepper motor. Here you can control not only this it's a bit a small motor. You can have a, you can control a very the biggest motors used in heavy machines also using the same PLC board. So that is the beauty of the PLC, right? But of late I learned the Arduino more recently only. I came to know now from it, after learning the Arduino, especially from the point of view of stepper motor, this will be much cheaper. It is a damn cheap, yeah, 300 rupees, 200-300 rupees Arduino nano board can control at least five stepper motors sequentially, if not continuously or parallelly. So that is well and good, right? Whereas you see the cost of a high speed PLC, the well above 6000 or 8000 or so. Okay, so that's it for today. So if you like this, you please subscribe my channel and inform this to other students and faculty members, so then they'll also get some info through my sessions. Thank you.